Dear students, my colleagues and friends, I am Dr. P.K. Verma. Today I shall discuss the origin, discoveries, properties of various viral species. This lecture is very important because of the pandemic corona. A number of people want to know what are the viruses, whether these are living organisms or non-living particles, how they come into our body and behave as pathogenic. So, in the first session of this lecture, I shall discuss about the discoveries and early informations on viruses, and then I shall take examples of the some of the viruses which are pathogenic to mankind. At first, we should define what are the infectious diseases. When a pathogen, an external agent like virus, bacteria or protozoa, sometimes the helminthus, enter into our body, they disturb our metabolism and cause diseases. That is, these diseases develop because of infections of the foreign agents. The infectious diseases are communicable, but they may be contagious or non-contagious. Contagious diseases spread when the healthy person comes in closer contact of the diseased person, and therefore corona also can be called a contagious disease because it can attack a person coming within 6 feet distance. Its droplets can spread in air by sneezing and coughing, and it is said that it can come out through the gases, the anal gases coming out during farting. So, out of many of the pathogens, the viruses, bacteria, fungi, protozoa and helminthus. In this lecture, I am confined only to the viruses and viral diseases. A virus is a submicroscopic infectious agent that replicates only inside the living cell of an organism. Neither out of the cell nor inside a dead cell it can multiply, because it is regarded as acellular. That means it is not a cell, and without having a cellular structure no one can become alive or can be categorized as living, and because of that in no classification in the biology 2 kingdom, 3 kingdom, 4 kingdom, 5 kingdom or the six kingdom classifications, virus has been included. Viruses infect all types of life forms, from animals and plant to the microorganisms, including bacteria and archaea. Now come to the discovery of virus. In 1892, the Russian biologist Dmitry Ivanovsky used a bacterial filter to study what is known as now tobacco mosaic virus. The tobacco mosaic virus damaged leaves of tobacco, make them brown and porous. So Ivanovsky crushed leaf extracts from the infected tobacco plant and filtered using the bacterial filter. He found that after filtration, the liquid was still infectious, and when the drops of liquids were poured over other tobacco leaves, the mosaic disease developed in them. So it could not be the intact bacteria. Ivanovsky suggested the infection might be caused by a toxin produced by bacteria, but did not pursue the idea. In 1898, the Dutch microbiologist Martinus Beijerinck repeated the experiment using bacterial filter and became convinced that the filtered solution contains a new form of infectious agent. He observed that the agent multiplied only in the cells that were dividing. But as his experiments did not show that it was made of a particle, he called it contagium vivum fluidum. That means a soluble substance that behaves like a germ, and reintroduced the term virus, that means toxic substance. In the same year, Frederick Loeffler and Paul Frost passed the first animal virus, ephthovirus, that causes foot and mouth disease through a similar filter system. The first image of virus were obtained upon the invention of electron microscope in 1931 by the German engineers Ernst Ruska and Max Noll. In 1935, American biochemist and virologist Wendell Meredith Stanley examined the tobacco mosaic virus and separated them into protein and RNA parts. That is, the plant viruses, it is almost universally correct that the plant viruses are made of RNA and protein. Only a few plant viruses, such as the cauliflower mosaic virus, is DNA virus. But most other plant viruses are made of RNA and protein. Wendell Stanley proved they were particulate. That is, these were very fine particles under the size micrometer. Their size is measured in terms of nanometer. The tobacco mosaic virus was the first to be crystallized, and the first X-ray diffraction picture of the crystallized virus were obtained by Bernal and Feng Kuchen in 1941. On the basis of her X-ray crystallographic picture, Rosalind Franklin discovered the full structure of virus in 1955. Rosalind Franklin was a virologist, a microbiologist, but she is also honored as she took the photograph of DNA crystal on the basis of which Watson, Crick and Wilkins were awarded Nobel Prize. But before getting the Nobel Prize, unfortunately, Rosalind Franklin died in 1958. In the same year, Conrad and William showed that the purified TMB, RNA and its protein, quote, can assemble by themselves to form functional viruses. That is, if the RNA and protein both are mixed together in a solution, they aggregate together forming the full structure of tobacco mosaic virus. That is, they have the self-aggregation property. It is very much helpful in producing new generation of the virus within the host cells. Now see the diagram here. This TMB mosaic virus is a rod-shaped structure with 300 angstrom length and 180 angstrom in diameter. It has a helical form of long RNA molecule, and on the RNA, the unit proteins called capsids or capsomeres become attached, forming a very peculiar structure. So these capsomeres are the unit protein that become attached to the surface of RNA. The same is shown here, and in the right side, in the figure C, the structure of protein has been shown. It has an inner loop. When it forms the secondary structure, here is the inner loop, and the amino and carboxyl terminals are towards one side. When infected, a host cell is forced to rapidly produce thousands of identical copies of the original virus by synthesizing its genetic material and protein. When not inside a cell or in the process of infecting a cell, viruses exist in the form of independent particles or virions consisting of the following. It has the genetic material, that is a long molecule of DNA or RNA that encodes the structure of protein by which the virus acts. Second part is a protein coat, the capsid, that surrounds and protects the genetic material, and in some cases, such as in human immunodeficiency virus HIV, there is an outside envelope of lipid. The shape of these viral particles range from simple helical and icosahedral forms to more complex structures. In 1928, Maitland and Maitland grew vaccinia virus in suspension of minced hen's kidney. Their method was adapted to grow polio virus on a large scale for vaccine preparation in 1950s. The second half of 20th century, that is after 1950s, was the golden age of virus discovery, and most of the documented species of animal, plant and bacterial viruses were discovered during this period. In 1957, equine arterivirus, the cause of bovine virus diarrhea, a pesty virus, were discovered. In 1963, hepatitis B virus was discovered by Baruch Blumberg, and in 1965, Howard Temin described the first retrovirus. Temin and Baltimore also discovered the enzyme reverse transcriptase that helps in formation of a complementary copy of DNA single strand on the RNA of virus. In 1983, Luc Montagnier and his team at the Pasteur University Institute in France isolated the retrovirus HIV. In 1989, Michael Houghton team at Chiron Corporation discovered hepatitis C. So all these discoveries are very recent, and we are working on various species of virus. We are trying to find out the structure of their genome, various proteins acting as antigens in them, so that the proper vaccine can be made against most of them affecting human body. You all might be knowing about the smallpox virus, that before 1970 killed 1 person per family in India. Here it was called Bari Mata. This photograph is that of a smallpox virus that has a detailed structure like this. Although it is controlled, it is sometimes debated whether it will come back or it has already been completely destroyed from nature. There are many giant viruses. The Pandora virus, Pandora virus salinus, is the largest one with a size about 1000 nanometer. Sorry, here 100 is written, but it is 1000 nanometer, containing 2541 protein units. Another is the megavirus chilensis, containing 440 nm size and 1120 proteins. The mama virus has third position, 390 nm. Another is the mimi virus, not mummy virus, it is mimi virus of the same size, 390 nm. Cafeteria Roenbergensis virus has 300 nm diameter. So these are some of the large viruses or the giant viruses. The Pandora virus salinus is a species of giant virus first discovered in 2013, very recently. It is largest in physical size that has double-stranded DNA genome, with the largest genome size about 2.5 million base pairs. It is larger than the genome of any other known virus. It was discovered by a team of French scientists led by husband and wife team, Jean-Michel Clavery and Quentin Auvergel. The result was published in July 2013 in the International Journal Science. Many viruses are there in different animals, including the amoeba-like organism that we do not know, and we have to discover them. Viruses are the submicroscopic and subcellular particles made of DNA or RNA coated with a specific protein codes. The unit proteins are called capsids or capsomere. Capsid is the cover of protein, and the unit protein is called capsomere. Many of the viral proteins are strong antigens, reacting with our body and interfere the normal metabolism, and therefore they are strongly pathogenic. Some viral diseases are often deadly. It can kill the mankind. Now see a list of some of the common viruses. Chickenpox, a common disease, is a DNA virus with double-stranded DNA. It belongs to a group of herpes virus and spreads by contact and with droplets. The herpes simplex is another DNA virus. It spreads by bite of the insects. Poliomyelitis, very small virus, belong to the group picornavirus, is RNA virus. It spreads by food and water. The common cold is caused by a rhinovirus, a RNA virus that spreads by droplet infection. Influenza and rabies also are RNA virus. Influenza is a orthomyxovirus spread by droplet infections, whereas rabies is a rhabdovirus. It spreads by contact and body fluid, also with the bite of a wild animal. Mumps, RNA virus of the group paramyxovirus, spreads by droplets. Measles, RNA virus, it is also paramyxovirus, but spreads by contact as well as droplets. Dengue fever, a reader fever, also develops due to RNA virus called flavivirus. It spreads by mosquito bite. Yellow fever, similar to dengue, belongs to arbovirus. It also spreads by mosquito bite. Chikungunya, it is RNA virus of the group tangovirus or alpha virus. It also spread by mosquito bite. AIDS, it contains two molecules of RNA. It is a retrovirus and spreads by contact of body fluid, sexually transmitted, or due to transfusion of the infected blood. SARS-1 and the COVID-19 और COVID-19 इज RNA वायरस, इट इज अ कोरोना वायरस, इट ऑल्सो स्प्रेड बाय कॉन्टैक्ट एंड ड्रॉपलेट्स. सो दीज आर द कॉमन वायरसेज इन्फेक्टिंग ह्यूमन बींग. एंड रिसेंटली दिस SARS-2 और COVID-19 हैज बिकम ए पैंडेमिक एंड डैमेज द इकोनॉमी ऑफ ऑल कंट्रीज इन एंटायर वर्ल्ड. नाउ सी द फोटोग्राफ ऑफ द मीजल वायरस. वायरस इज ऑलवेज लुक वेरी ब्यूटिफुल बट दीज आर ऑलवेज हार्मफुल. वी हैव नो रिपोर्ट अबाउट एनी यूजफुल वायरस, एनी बेनिफिशियल वायरस. HIV, ह्यूमन इम्यूनोडेफिशियंसी वायरस, इज अनदर वेरी ब्यूटिफुल वायरस. इट हैज ए लिपिड बायलेयर हेयर. दिस पार्ट इज द लिपिड बायलेयर दैट बिलोंग्स टू द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन ऑफ द लिम्फोसाइट इन विच इट ग्रोज. नाउ द SARS वायरस दैट बिकेम पैंडेमिक इन 2003, 2005 and 2007 ऑलमोस्ट 50% ऑफ द कंट्रीज सफर्ड विथ इट्स आउटब्रेक. एंड इट इज ए कोरोना वायरस बट नाउ ए डे द कोरोना इज कॉल्ड नोबेल कोरोना. इट इज ए न्यू स्पेसीज. सी दिस फोटोग्राफ एंड द मॉडल ऑफ कोरोना वायरस. इट इज अनदर RNA वायरस. When a virus infects our body, it introduces its genetic material into our cell and its copies are made by our cell along with the antigenic toxin, proteins, enzymatic proteins and capsid or capsomeres. Thus the host cell produces new generation of virus and virus itself cannot reproduce. When the DNA or RNA comes into the host cell does not recognize them as a foreign substance, and therefore its copies are made normally as the copies of own DNA or RNA is made inside the host cell. The viral genome contains all those genes which are essential for synthesis of various viral proteins, and therefore these proteins also are formed inside the host cell. Now after formation of the nucleic acid and the viral proteins, they assemble together and form the new generation of virus. So they compel the host cell to produce their generation. The animals are attacked with RNA as well as DNA viruses. I have given examples of 2 or 3 DNA viruses, rest were the RNA viruses. But most of the pathogenic viruses are RNA viruses or ribaviruses. Viral diseases in man can be classified into 4 groups as below. This is the diagram showing formation of the copies of RNA. Now transcription of the genes and their translation into proteins on the ribosome of the host cell. These proteins are synthesized in the cell itself, and they aggregate together to form the new generation of virus. So these viruses that cause the diseases in human or other animals have been categorized into four types. One is the pneumotropic virus, that is, they cause pneumotropic viral diseases, infect the respiratory tract. Influenza, common cold, SARS and corona are the pneumotropic viral species. Second is dermatotropic viral diseases. They infect the skin and other epithelial surfaces, chickenpox, smallpox, measles, herpes simplex are dermatotropic viral species. Third one is viscerotropic viral diseases. They attack the internal organs. Yellow fever, dengue fever, hepatitis A and B, AIDS, etc. are viscerotropic viral diseases. And there are some neurotropic viral diseases. They infect the nervous system, for example, rabies, polio, and encephalitis. So you know now the structure of a virus, and diseases like chickenpox, measles, poliomyelitis, common cold, influenza, rabies, mumps, dengue fever and yellow fever, as well as the chikungunya, AIDS and the SARS and corona. Bird flu also develops due to viruses. In the next session, we shall discuss how our body defends themselves from various infections, including the viral infection. Thank you. Thank you.